and his mercy in the world forever. Amen. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is what? And his what? Mercy endureth forever. Amen. Then he goes on to say, let be redeemed of the Lord, what? Amen. Say that again. Let thee who?
Redeemed of the Lord.
Let them do what?
Say so.
All right. Let them redeem. How many have been redeemed?
Amen.
How many glad that you're saved?
Amen.
How many glad that you're redeemed? Redeemed from the curse. Delivered from the power of darkness. Amen. Satan's dominion over your life has been broken. That's what it means to be redeemed. Praise
Amen.
God. Amen. We have a song that the angels can't sing. Been redeemed, been washed in the blood of the Lamb. Amen. I'm just so thankful this morning for all of you that's here. And we want to say that this is a new year. And we just believe that great things are in store for us this year. Many are saying that this year is going to be a year that will usher in the very last events of this age. Amen. So we just want to make sure that this year is the year that we will take special measures in bringing our lives and preparing ourselves. How many believe the coming of the Lord is close? Amen. Praise God. The closer the coming of the Lord, the coming of the Lord is, that means that the more diligent the people of the Lord should be what? Preparing for his coming. How many believe that we need to be prepared?
Amen. Amen.
Amen. I'm not getting all amen. Amen. How do we prepare for his coming? Amen. The Bible tells us exactly how to prepare for the coming of the Lord. So we just want to focus this year quite a bit on the imminent coming of the Lord Jesus, and we're going to get back on that message before too long. And I think that this is the season that we want to make sure that we are actually carrying out the will of God, because if Jesus is coming, and if he's coming soon, that means that we need to be about our Father's business.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. And last week, we ministered on following the example of Jesus. Amen. Whatever Jesus did, whatever example he set, that's the thing that we need to be patterning our lives after, because Jesus is coming soon. Amen. Jesus is coming soon. How many want to be at your desk? How many want to be ready?
Amen.
Amen. How many want to be asleep and be ashamed at his appearing? Amen. Nobody. Is that right? Amen. So I'm going to be sharing things that will motivate you. You know, I can't force anybody to do anything, but it's my responsibility to pave the way and to lead you and to teach you and to instruct you and even to guide you in a way in which will prepare you for the imminent return of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So I'm just going to pray. I'm going to give you some information. I'm going to tell you what we need to be studying, what we need to be doing. And we're going to talk about things that will prepare us for the imminent return of Christ. And today we're going to be sharing following the example of Jesus. Let's bow our heads just for a moment. Father, we thank you for your greatness, your goodness, your love, your many blessings, and all the things that you've done. We thank you, Father, for beginning the good work within us, and you who have begun the good work, you shall continue to perform it. Father, our eyes are on you. Oh God, you're the author, you're the finisher. Glory, hallelujah. Lord, we're trusting you, we're looking to you. Hallelujah. Father, today we expect you, Father, to speak through us and to lead and to direct all that we say, all that we do. And we'll give you praise as we delight in you. Lord, you said if we delight in you, you will give us the desires of our hearts. And you said if we would rejoice, Fear not and rejoice. You will do great things. And Father, we are expecting great things because we are going to Job. We are going to do our part. Hallelujah. We are going to obey and walk in the word of God. We'll give you the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Everybody said in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I want you to turn back to Philippians. We're so happy today for Sister Neil. She's out for practice. She's not that she wanted to be. Amen. But did we miss her last week?
Yeah.
All right. She wasn't here last week to explain me. And we went over time last week, so she needs to be. All right. Well, she's there today. She told me, I'm going on here. Philippians 2:5, it says, look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. So if there ever were a time that we need to be really, really, really concerned about ministering to others, blessing others, showing mercy and compassion to others, I feel like this is a great part of God's plan for us to prepare for His coming. Amen. If God is merciful, if God is full of compassion, amen. If God is interested in the things which concern us, then this is the same mind and attitude that we should have as believers. You can't go wrong if you will emulate the pattern or the example of Jesus. Amen. And that's where the blessings are. If you really want to be blessed, amen. If you really want to experience God's best, how many want to experience God's best 2012? Amen. And I think the closer we get to the coming of Jesus, the more pressure we're going to feel from the forces of the enemy. More trials, more heartaches and troubles and conflicts and more deception and more temptation to get distracted from the true and narrow way. So we want to understand that if we want to maximize our blessings and to place ourselves in a position where God's grace can reach us and we can be recipients of God's richest blessings, we have to follow His example. The scripture says, blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain what?
Mercy.
So if you really want mercy, when I say mercy, I mean more grace. If you really want to experience God's best, then let's begin to switch the focus from off of ourselves. Amen. The things which concerns us. Scripture says, look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. In other words, get involved in what? Amen. Sharing with others, blessing others, showing mercy to others. I mean, this is the key to spiritual victory. Amen. This is the key. Nothing else will take the place, amen, of showing mercy. Amen. It was yesterday. I had several homes that I wanted to go into, and I tell you, I just didn't feel like, amen, making all those rounds. Amen. How many ever felt that way? Amen. But I know that whenever I need motivation, whenever I need more zeal and more inspiration, and I need, amen, a little bit more fervency, I just need more, amen, something that I'm not experiencing, I know that that is one of the main ways that I can really get pumped up.
Yes.
Amen. So I just push myself, when I'm out there, amen, the first home I went to, it was a visitor that had been here a few weeks back, and she had a pacemaker that the cord broke, the wire in her pacemaker had broken, and she was experiencing excruciating pains all over her body. And She had experienced this for several days, and finally she went to emergency, and they turned the battery off, and that helped to alleviate a lot of the pain. But she was in much fear because she knew that pacemaker wasn't working, and she could have a stroke or a heart attack or anything at any point. So you're going to find people in all types of distressful situations. And the thing that I was able to do, I just took one of the little books, How to Live a Stress-Free Life in a Troubled World. And at the back of that book, I just had a whole lot of the prayers. Talked about casting your cares and even how to trust God for your healing and your deliverance. I just had a whole series of scriptures in the back of that little book. And I just took the book out and just began to read. Amen. I just began to read how to cast your cares. Amen. How to trust God. How to get victory over fear and anxiety. Amen. And as a result of that, amen, I was able to release the anointing in her life, and she was just so uplifted, and I was able to leave the material there with her, and we just had a time of rejoicing, and I was able to minister to the entire family. Amen. So needless to say, when I left that home, I was on cloud 13. Amen. Sometimes you just get tired and sick, and you watch the news, and you watch this and watch that, and sometimes when you're not constantly and consistently reaching out and doing things to minister, to bless others, and to help others, I don't know about y'all, I just start feeling blah. I don't know how to describe it. Now, y'all, anybody have a better word than that? I just feel like something is missing. I just don't feel that real joy. Although nothing has changed, haven't backslidden, but the secret to our completeness is in what? Showing mercy. Yes. I believe that we're going to find out that we're going to be at our best, and all of the anointing, all of the teachings and all of the scriptures and all that tied up, bottled up in you, is going to be released as you go out and what? Show mercy. That is the key. Then I was able to go by another home. Amen. And this member of our church, and I was able to pray with her and her family. And needless to say, amen, I went up another notch. Amen. After I left that home. So this year we want to understand that if we want more mercy, if we want more mercy, everybody say, if I want more mercy, I'm going to have to show more mercy. That's the way you get more mercy. When we say more mercy, it simply means more grace. More grace. Amen. And God has a lot of grace. The Bible says, amen, He's able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can think or ask, according to the power that worketh in us. And even after I left that home, I just went around just knocking on doors. Amen. Praise God. And I went to the home of a lady that was a widow. Her husband was a doctor. Everybody would know him if I could call his name. But he passed away some times ago. And I went by and just talked to her. Amen. Amen. Praise God. I had met her somewhere before, and I said, I'm going to come down, I'm going to bring you something. Amen. So last night, I delivered my package. Amen. So I'll be connecting back with her, amen, in a few days. So I just want to get everybody busy, involved in showing mercy, showing compassion. How many believe that you would like to do this too? You would love a ministry. If I, amen, figure out a ministry that would fit you and be something that you really would like, amen, would you be willing to pay the price, make a sacrifice, amen, and lay down your life, and amen, and take your attention off of your stuff and Amen. What you're going through, what you got to do, what you got over here. Amen. I know all of us got stuff to do. I always have something to do. Is that right? But the scripture says we're not to look. Amen. Not every man on his what? Own things, but every man also on the things of others. If you want to be happy, amen, that's the key, because the scripture says, let this man. Amen. I'm endeavoring to to knock on a whole bunch of doors. I'm gonna try to do 100 doors before the month is over. Amen. I'm gonna try. Amen. If I come short, amen. If I don't hit what's the furthest? The stars or the moon? If I don't hit the moon, amen. If I can just hit the stars or vice versa, amen. I still be what? Flying real high. I still be shooting high. What? Amen. So I have another passage today. Amen. This is going to be something that will revolutionize the church. Now, I think all of us are just tired of just coming to church, and not using and taking advantage of the anointing that you are receiving from coming to church. Amen. So I just want to encourage you. We're going to meet with you briefly after church is over, but we're going to ask you to be here Wednesday night. We're going to ask you to be here possibly Wednesday night. We'll know whether we need Saturday and next Sunday after church, amen, to really begin to give out all of these assignments and get everybody involved and get everybody focused, amen. And after we get everybody focused and everybody in some particular aspect of the ministry, amen, then we're going to start praying. Amen. We don't want to do nothing without prayer. Amen. Because you don't know what to do. You don't know how to do it, right? Amen. Praise God. So we're going to get everybody committed. And if you don't follow through with your commitment, it's not going to be my fault. Amen. Whose fault will it be? Amen. All right. I want you to look at 2 Corinthians 5:14. It says this. For the love of God, love of Christ, constraineth us, because we thus judge that if one died for all, then we're all dead. Then we're all dead. And that he died for all, that they which live should not henceforth live unto themselves. And that's another scripture. And that he died for all. Amen. See, Jesus, amen, he gave his life for all of us. Bible says, perceive, we read this last week, perceive ye the love of God, because he laid down his life for us. Amen. So if Christ laid down his life for us, then the Bible says we ought to lay down our lives, amen, for the brothers. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. We need to lay down our lives for the brothers. Okay? That scripture goes on and says, wherefore, okay, and that he died for all, that they should not henceforth live unto themselves, but unto him which what? Died for them and what? Rose again. So our lives should be focused around pleasing the Lord in every aspect of our life. Whatever Christ was interested, whatever he told us to do, that's the thing that we need to be following. That's the thing that we need to be building our lives around. He's our best example, and if we follow his example, we will have a full and rich, complete life. Amen. How many want to have a full, complete life? Amen. Now, I want you to look at the example of Jesus. We kind of went over this last week, but I am a repetitious teacher. Amen. And it says this, Matthew 4:23, and Jesus went about all Galilee, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing all manner of sickness and all manner of disease among the people. Amen. That was the beginning of Jesus' ministry. So that's the pattern that we are to follow. I want you to look at Luke 4:18, and you will see something that Jesus said specifically that relate to all of us. Amen. Luke 4:18. Amen. This scripture says, The Spirit of the Lord, this is what Jesus read when he, when the book of Isaiah was delivered to him in the temple. This is what he began to read. This is when he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and his custom, in the 16th verse says, as he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up for to read. Amen. And this is what he read. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Amen. Now all of us can agree with that. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised. Amen. So, saying it in simple terms, Jesus' ministry was going about, Scripture says in Acts 10:38, how God anointed Jesus with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good. Amen. That's what Acts 10:38, how God anointed Jesus with the Holy Ghost and with what? Power, who went about doing good, healing, amen, healing. You know, people need all types of healing. Amen. Some need financial healing. Some need what? Emotional healing. Some need mental healing. The lady yesterday, she needed mental, emotional healing. She needed physical healing. Amen. Amen. But this scripture says that Jesus said that this was his what? His mission. And this mission that Jesus articulated here is the same mission that pertains to all of us as believers. We need to be doing something, amen, that will what? Cause us to what? To minister, to reach out. Amen. I mean, there's many, 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 many things that we can do as believers. Amen. To reach out and to help people that are in distress. People that need healing, whether it's spiritual, physical, mental, emotional, or whatever arena it might be. This is the mission that all of us have been called to do. And we will never, never, never be successful. We will never, never be truly fulfilled until we are actually, amen, diverting their attention from all of the things that pertain to us and getting them what? Focus on the things that pertain to us. Because we call this walking in love. Amen. Praise God. So the Bible says, perceive ye the love of Christ because he laid down his life for his what? For us. Amen. He did all of this for us. The scripture says that we ought to be willing to lay down our lives for his what? For his five brothers. Not only for our brothers, but for all of those that are in need. And last week, remember, we read the story. This was in Luke 10:11, concerning the man that fell among thieves. That was a good illustration. Now, Jesus gave some really good illustration, the lost son. Amen. And he gave illustrations about the man that fell among thieves. Amen. And that scripture in Luke, I'm trying to turn to that right now. It was the scripture that showed us our responsibility as believers in terms of ministering to those who have needs. Now, Jesus called this man a man that showed mercy. And he called him his neighbor. Amen. He called him his neighbor. Amen. And the Bible mentioned about that, this was in Luke 10, verses 31 through 36. And we went over there last week. This was concerning a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho, fell among thieves, which stripped him of his raiment, wounded him, departed, leaving him half dead. And by chance, this is a good illustration, there by chance came down a certain priest that way. When he saw him, he passed down the other side. And likewise a Levite, when he was at the place, came and looked on him, passed by on the other side. Amen. And this kind of describes the lifestyle that most believers are living today. Amen. We sometimes notice people, but many times we are not motivated. We are not led and move to the point where we will come to their rescue and many minister something that will cost their life, amen, to be more, amen, complete. And likewise, the Levite, which when he was at the place, came and looked on him and passed by on the other side. But a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, now we want to have a spirit of a Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had what? Compassion on him. Amen. Praise God. All this compassion, all these compassion scriptures we've been reading about Jesus, amen, and how he loves us and how he wants us to be blessed, and amen, it's God's good pleasure to give us the kingdom. He daily loaded us with benefits, and he's given us everything that pertains unto life. Amen. His mercies are new every morning, and the Lord God is a sun and shield. He gives grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold. Amen. From them that walk upright. Amen. That's the spirit that we're trying to attain unto. Hey, how many want to be like Jesus?
Amen.
How many really want to be like Jesus? I mean, that, y'all send us, oh, glory. You said it with reservation. Oh, I don't know. It's the price I have to pay. You true. Amen. If any man comes after me, he has to what? Deny himself, take up the cross, and what?
Follow me.
See, the Samaritan was the person that showed what? Mercy. He's the one that came to their rescue. How many know there are people around us, amen, that we need to what? Help rescue. We need to what? Minister. We need to what? Go where they are and find out exactly what we can do, amen, to show mercy to them. Amen. Now, here's what the Samaritan did. He went on. He went to him, bound up his wound. Wasn't that nice of him? Amen. The Levite, the preacher, and the teacher, they just what? Passed by, looked at him, and said, oh, he sure looks bad. Why is this? He bled. Somebody beat this man up, didn't he? Yeah, he sure got beat up bad. Oh, he sure looks sad. I wonder who did that. Amen. They had all of these ideas and said all these things. Perhaps, but they didn't do anything. You know, you have a whole lot of people talk, but you don't have, sometimes we talk it by the mile and what? Walk it by the inch. Amen. So it's not the talk of the law that's justified. It's the what? Do. Amen. Amen. I was talking to a pastor the other day, and I said, Pastor, you think this man will ever do anything? Amen. He said, no, he's a big talker. He ain't going to do it. Pastors know their membership. Amen. So this Samaritan went to him, bound up his wounds, poured in oil and wine, and set him on his own beast, and brought him to an inn, and took care of him. And on the morrow, when he departed, he took out 2 pence, gave them to the host, and said unto him, take care of him, whatsoever thou spendest more, when I come again, I will repay thee. Which now of these, this is the question that Jesus asked, which now of these three, thinkest thou, was the neighbor unto him that fell among the thieves? And he said, he that showed mercy. Now Jesus was talking to the man that came to him, and this was a very intelligent man, and he was a certain lawyer. Amen. He wanted to know how he could get the blessings of the Lord released into his life. And he said, well, amen. Jesus initially told him, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, soul, mind, and strength. And to love thy neighbor as thyself. Amen. But the question came up, who is my neighbor? Who is my neighbor? Amen. Praise God. So Jesus was answering that question. Your neighbor is the person, amen, that you are coming in contact with daily that has a need that you can what? Meet. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. So that's the type of attitude the Lord wants us to what? Seek out people that have needs that you are what? Coming into contact with. It doesn't always mean you have to what? Pull out $50, $100 and what? Meet their need. Yesterday, the lady didn't say anything about money. She just wanted to get free from fear. She just wanted to make sure that she won't have a heart attack. Amen. Amen. While that pacemaker was not what? Working. She wanted that assurance. Amen. And how much did it cost Pastor Hill to go over there and just share it with her? He just took my gas money. Amen. I had some gas. Amen. Praise God. So he'll buy my tank of gas every week. I don't have to worry about gas. Amen. Hallelujah. How many can say praise the Lord? So, hallelujah. This is the message that God wants us to know, that we are to what? Follow the example of Jesus. Now, I'm going to show you the reason why Jesus was always, amen, connecting with people in a way in which he could always get the results that he was seeking. It was a certain discipline. Glory. It was a certain discipline that we're going to be doing this week that enabled Jesus to be very effective in connecting with people. Amen. Now, Wednesday night, we had a very interesting discussion, and sometimes, we were discussing Wednesday night, why is it on Sunday many times you have people that come and visit, they're sometimes sitting around us, behind us, and across the deal from us, and many times when visitors leave the audience, many times they will leave without even being touched by anybody, but just a few people. There are some people that's always trying to reach out. But many times people can see visitors, they don't know who they are, they don't try to find out who they are. They might have some needs, they might have some problems, they might have some things that they could minister. Amen. They could possibly make their life a whole lot better. But many times we never place ourselves in a position where we can connect with people, amen, and just try to relate to them and find out more about them. So, amen, the door or the avenue to minister to them can become a reality. And we began to ask those that were here, amen, why is it many times people just draw back and they don't have a desire to walk up to people and say, baby, who are you? I'm Pastor Hill, or amen, I'm Sister Canola. Amen. And you are who? Amen. So, and maybe just hold a brief conversation. Many times when you talk to people just a little bit, is that right? They begin to what? Pull out their problems. Pull out their needs. They'll tell you something about them. Amen. It doesn't take a whole lot of time and knowledge and skill and experience to do that. Amen. Sometimes, amen. And the question came up, why is it that many times we draw back and we just don't do it? And then, amen, some very important information came to light. Amen. Some people said, well, I just don't feel